Hi, I'm Arzu Kalaycı, live from AHA 2019. Today I'm joined by Dr. Pinilla, who has just presented the substudy of complete trial, which was the optical coherence tomography substudy. Welcome, Dr. Pinilla. So could you please tell us about background and the design of the trial?
So first of all, thank you for having me here. The complete trial, as you know, was a randomized multinational trial that was just published in the New England Journal in October this year. We randomized over 4,000 patients, and the complete trial showed that a complete revascularization strategy compared to cold preclusion only PCI reduced the primary outcome of cardiovascular death or new myocardial infarction in 26%. And when we added to the secondary co-primary outcome, ischemia-driven revascularization, the risk with a complete revascularization strategy was reduced half. So whether or no this benefit of doing PCI in the non-culprit disease in this population is related to underlying vulnerable plaque is unclear. The OCT complete sub-study helped us to understand that. So in patients with a STEMI and successful culprit lesion PCI, coming back for a stage procedure for a stage non-culprit lesion PCI, we performed multivessel imaging in 93 patients. The insights of this sub-study is that obstructive non-culprit lesions are most likely to have vulnerable plaque, defined as TICFA, thin cut fibroteroma. Our definition was fibrous cap thickness below 65 micrometers overlying a lipidic plaque. And definitely the obstructive lesions have higher percentage of vulnerable plaque.
So you found that obstructive lesions tended to be vulnerable, right, mostly? Mm-hmm. So do you think, was it because of the process, inflammatory process of STEMI, or do you think they were the same before that?
So actually, this is very important in the STEMI population because we believe the STEMI population had higher risks of future cardiovascular events, and it may be all related to the inflammatory process that is behind. This is telling us that these patients had definitely higher risks because they had vulnerable plaques far from the culprit segment. This is reassuring that acute coronary syndrome implies a diffuse pathophysiology with vulnerable plaque not only in the culprit segment, but in places far away from the culprit lesion. Actually, these results are supporting the findings in the complete trial that considering doing a non-culprit lesion PCI is good for the patients.
Okay, what about the non-obstructive lesion?
It was surprising the amount of disease we found in this sub-study. Performing multivessel imaging, we found in total 425 segments with disease in only 93 patients, so a diffuse pathophysiology. So we found over 200 non-obstructive, non-culprit lesions in those segments, and they could be TICFA or non-TICFA. What was surprising is like the obstructive TICFA and non-obstructive TICFA had same plaque characteristics. You had the same vulnerability. They are only different because the obstructive TICFAs are longer and have a smaller minimum lumen area, but the plaque composition behind those lesions are the same.
So the clinical implication of OCT is important.
So we believe we wanted to demonstrate like a mechanistic behavior behind those lesions because before we were not sure what was the benefit related to. Now, within this help us to understand that the benefit is because underlying these obstructive non-culprit lesions, there is a very high percentage of vulnerable plaque.
Congratulations on the study and thank you so much for joining us today. Thanks to all of you for joining us today, AHA 2019.
Thank you.
Thank you.